Talk about. Whoa, oh, mercy me. All things ain't what they used to be. No, no. Where did all the blue skies go? Cause is the wind that blows from north and south and east. Whoa, mercy me. All things ain't what they used to be. No, no. All wasted on the ocean and upon our seas. Fish full of mercury. Ooh, mercy me. All things ain't what they used to be.
Ooh, I better stop. But y'all know that's exactly when you look and think about what is happening to our environment and the people who are doing it, the people who are causing it. When you call them out for the destruction of the planet, they begin to blame everything and everybody. Just like the supreme narcissist that they are. All I know is we got to do better about the planet. Otherwise, it ain't going to be no planet. Can't you see the signs of the time? But anyway, let me get into this trailer that I saw today. And, you know, the trailer bought, it has such a profound effect on me. I did not know. Oh my goodness. I thought I knew, just like a lot of y'all think that you know, until something really, really rattles your cage to really let you see just how conquered we are as a people, as people of African descent. And I gotta say it. I gotta talk about it. So when I seen all of the responses to these, a lot of folk seeing Halle Bailey playing Ariel, and just the madness that they expounded on. Well, let me just let it speak for itself.
Halle Bailey as Ariel is fantastic, and you're just so off the bat. Mermaids aren't real. Folklore, a mermaid is an aquatic creature with the head and upper body of a female human and the tail of a fish. They appear in folklore from Europe, Asia, and Africa, but because a lot of you keep trying to bring up the source material, here is where the source material of mermaids comes from, the Mediterranean Sea. As you can see, we have Asia, Europe, and Africa, which means that a mermaid could be literally any skin color, but I get it. Atlantica is in Denmark. Fun fact, moron. Denmark has black people. Did you know that? Also, H.C. Andersen's original text, which the original movie is based off of, didn't actually clarify anywhere that Ariel was white. He just said that her skin was as clear and delicate as a rose leaf. I personally want to know Halle Bailey's skincare routine, because she looks great. You know, but like, her hair isn't as red as the cartoon, and her eyes aren't as blue as the sea. But guess what? Shut up. Does that serve the story? No. This just in. Breaking news. The skin color of Ariel serves absolutely nothing to the plot of The Little Mermaid. And that brings us to the next stupid fucking point that we keep bringing up. What if the roles were reversed? What if Mulan was white? What if Princess Tiana was white? Your dance, Mulan, Chinese, based on the traditional Chinese poem, The Ballad of Mulan. In this story and movie adaptation, her ethnicity has literally everything to do with the story of everything. It is set in China. Mulan is Chinese. Tiana is based off of Chef Leah Chase, a real person. This movie is also entirely rooted in the fact that she is a black woman in 1920s New Orleans. The social commentary there that you might find upon rewatching it is that she's not taken seriously because not only is she a woman in poverty, but she's also black. So what's the difference between those aforementioned characters and Ariel from The Little Mermaid? I say again, Ariel's race contributes fucking nothing. The story isn't changing. The original cartoon isn't going to cease to exist once this movie comes out. You have your Ariel. It's nostalgic for you. Stop being racist and let young black girls grow up with that same nostalgia. Why don't they just make an original character then? Maybe they don't fucking want to. I don't really condone all these remakes, but whether you watch it or not is up to you.
For all of the people freaking out about Halle Bailey playing Ariel in The Little Mermaid, I just want to remind you of the time when Jake Gyllenhaal was in The Prince of Persia. How about when Scarlett Johansson was in Ghost in the Shell? Angelina Jolie in A Mighty Heart? Rooney Mara in Peter Pan? Elizabeth Taylor as Cleopatra? Mickey Rooney in Breakfast at Tiffany's? Tilda Swinton in Doctor Strange? Natalie Wood in West Side Story? And Mel Gibson in Passion of the Christ. What you might be feeling right now is when you're accustomed to privilege, equality feels like discrimination or oppression. And it must be a very strange feeling for you that as the world moves on and gets more and more diverse, you're not going to be in everything when you've been accustomed to being so. I just want to let you know that it's okay. You'll get through it. We have. And growing up all of our lives as minorities, this is exactly how we felt when we found out that source material that we loved was being adapted and the protagonist didn't look like us. But America is getting more and more diverse, and I also want to remind you that The Little Mermaid is a fictional fish.
I am sick and tired of the Halle Bailey Little Mermaid discourse and slander. Not my mermaid. She's not my mermaid. Shut up. Shut up right now. It is time for you to grow up, specifically millennials. Name one good reason why Halle Bailey, who is iconic, can sing better than most of the people in her generation, can act better than most people in her generation, should not have been casted for this role. And you cannot convince me that Halle Bailey does not look like a Disney princess. We all know why you don't want Halle Bailey to play Ariel. You know why as well. It's because she is black. Does that not make you feel sick inside? That you feel that this woman who is someone's daughter, someone's sister, someone's friend, representation in media is less capable because she's black? It's a big boo-hoo for me that a black woman beat out all the little white girls that auditioned for this role. Just shut up and grow up.
So after the trailer was released, mothers filmed their daughters as they blindly react to the trailer. And oh my God, it made me so emotional. Like, I didn't know when tears started running down my cheeks. Representation really does matter. So up next is a compilation of the reaction of some of the kids to the trailer of the Little Mermaid live animation movie.
Disney has decided to cast Halle Bailey, a black woman, as Ariel in their upcoming release of The Little Mermaid.
Let me say this, family. Let me pause it for a minute. This is what broke my heart, because it allowed me as a black woman to actually, for that few minutes when I was engulfed in the trailer, to feel and to see the joy on the little black girls' faces. I thought about Dr. John Henry Clark when he did the first experiment with the black dial and the white dial. And of course, y'all know it still goes on today. And I thought about the children. And then I thought about what happens when you construct a world when nobody sees themselves in the world but you. And then you got the nerve to be upset because now the world is, the United States is beginning more and more to be representation of what the world is. The world is 9/10 black. and brown. So America is just catching up. It was always more black and brown people. It's just that y'all was so, and still are, so controlling that you can't deal with the fact that you've been fed lies. The whole world and the population is black and brown people. And we're all meant to live and inhabit this earth together. But when you grow up a group of people and their self-esteem is so bad because of the lies you've told and because of how bad they feel about themselves, when you see Ariel and the little girl's faces, oh my God. Let me shut up.
Right. And there have been a lot of opinions about this casting decision sprinkled around the internet. But I'm going to be honest with you, none of those opinions matter more to me than these little black girls.
Look on these little girls' faces.
She's black.
It showed me just how fucked up we really are. That these little kids and us have to have white people shoved down our goddamn throat. For generation after generation after generation after generation.
I was a little shocked.
And so much to the point where when you see the look on these little girls' faces, to see themselves, it's unbelievable. It's so moving.
That's the real her.
Because we've had them shoved down our throats so much. And this is the impact.
They
smell
like me.
What, baby?
They smell
like
me. Yeah, she's
smelling
like you.
She looks so pretty.
I'm
going to
watch it.
We're going to go see it when it comes out in the theater.
It's coming out in May.
2023?
Mm-hmm.
Is it almost
2020?
Just about, yeah.
I too saw Little Mermaid growing up, and I have seen it multiple times, even now as an adult. And now seeing a black woman playing Ariel, it makes me so emotional and happy. And I lowkey wish I was a child right now so I can, you know, get the experience as a child. I'm super excited for this one. I know it's going to be a great deal for black children all across the world, and I'm here for it.
So it has come to my attention that there is a thing going around, hashtag not my Ariel, that a lot of people are upset that Ariel will be now played by a black actress, which as an African, I'm not gonna lie, this stuff genuinely makes me laugh. Because mermaids are a huge part of my culture, and our mermaids look like this. Just Google Mamiwata. There's also the backlash with the House of Dragon and with the Rings of Power because, ooh, the idea of a black person being an elf and a troll is unfathomable. Clearly, you guys haven't heard about the Aziza fairies of West Africa or the Eloko, aka forest trolls from my country, But whatever. Personally, I haven't watched Rings of Power or House of Dragon. I've just gotten a bit bored of the whole European mythology fantasy aesthetic. I feel like we've seen it so many times that now I'm really craving something new. But since you guys want to be petty and you want to play this game, let's play this game. If we can be a part of your stuff, then why have you made yourself the face of ours? Did you know that the concept of zombies originates from Africa? The word zombie itself comes from my language, the Kikongo language of the Bakongo people. Zombie comes from us. So every time you're saying the word zombie, you better be crediting my ancestors. So since we are not allowed to be a part of your stuff, you guys are no longer allowed to tell zombie stories because it belongs to us. You see how two can play that game? In the name of my ancestors, I'm asking you guys to give zombie stories back. All the profits that have ever been made by any Western zombie film or TV show, you guys owe it to us. Give it back to Haiti and then give it back to the rest of the African diaspora. You see how two people can play this game. If Ariel is not supposed to be black, ding, 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 spoiler alert, zombies are not supposed to be white. Not at least according to the origin and meaning of zombies. And yet, here you guys are, making billion-dollar movies about zombies and not even crediting our ancestors. But did you see us get mad?
Besties, we are astonished and a little upset. So Black Diamond Productions released a teaser trailer for their highly anticipated live-action remake of The Little Fairy Princess. For those of you who don't know, The Little Fairy Princess follows Azuri. She's a fairy princess who falls in love with a human, and she gives up her wings to be with this human. It's really romantic. I feel like everybody's seen A Little Fairy Princess. But anyway, so in this live action remake, The Little Fairy Princess, I mean, as a meteorologist, from a science standpoint, it doesn't make sense that someone who lives that close to the sun would be so pale. It's not even about life. It's about science. Exactly. I mean, fairies look a certain way for a scientific reason. And she lives in the cloud kingdom, the fairy cloud kingdom above Nigeria. So it's impossible that she could look like that.
But she whacked, like Cleopatra.
Above Nigeria, then of course she's Nigerian. I think
kings of Egypt.
Facts, I think ignoring the verifiable science about
these people have damaged our minds so bad. And got the nerve.
Of a lot of comments like this, I have a confession to make. I once did indeed date a purple individual.
So I made that video a few months back, speaking on my experiences of being in a relationship with a purple person, making us an inter-rainbow couple. And I don't know if anyone on the entirety of the internet or on this clock app has heard that Disney is making a live-action Little Mermaid. And I'm fired up because no one is talking about the travesty of the purple face that is going to occur in this film. The purple face. It's giving violet fishing. This is giving coral troll a profanation. As someone who is a traditionalist, I don't understand how y'all can hire this white woman to play this beautiful purple queen. Y'all don't see the problem. Y'all don't see the problem with this because you don't have the experiences I have with dating purple people. Purple people have feelings, have rights, have dignity. And Hollywood has done the same thing that it continues to do over and over and over again, which is whitewash the purple people. Magenta and indigo erasure is real. Hollywood perpetuates this lie that they can never find purple actors and actresses to fulfill these roles. And it's bullshit. So while some of you are out there arguing about if mermaids are real, or can mermaids be black or white, or are there black Europeans, or are there black people in Denmark, I'm over here fighting the real fight for the purple fucking people. But seriously, on a serious note, what I find truly wild is that people are mad over the fact that Ariel's going to be black. But I've seen some of the same people, and I stalk comment sections, I've seen some of the same people say that Ursula should definitely be played by Queen Latifah or Lizzo.
Wow.
But why do some of y'all have no problem
with
a fat, femme-presenting villain being played by a Black woman.
So while I was on the streets of Twitter, I came by this tweet, and I think it's a good note to end this video on. I don't know why y'all are fighting with racists over Ariel's race. Just hit them with your favorite line, "Why are you bringing race into this?" Follow it up with, "Maybe she was the best person who auditioned," and then close it all up with the banger, "Not everything is about race." And on that note, guys, we've come to the end of this video. Thank you very much for watching. Let me know down below in the comment section what your thoughts are. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.
Now, this one really makes no scientific sense because Ariel lives in the bottom of the ocean, which means she gets no sunshine, which means her skin would be pale.
Oh, my God.
So we have now gotten to the point where we are using science as the excuse for the pigmentation of a mythological creature.
Great scientists here to tell you that, scientifically speaking, mermaids don't fucking exist. Now, scientifically speaking, in an alternate timeline or a different universe, if there were mermaids, they would rather be very blubbery, or if they were semi-aquatic, extremely hairy. And the idea that something that lives at the bottom of the ocean is pale is, scientifically speaking, incorrect. These darkest sea creatures, like darker than the pitch black ocean, live in the deep sea. So scientifically speaking, you saying that Ariel can't be black because she lives in the deep sea is just racist.
Number two, I don't know if you knew this, but white people aren't the only people with red or ginger hair. Us black folks have that too. Now, this is the question that I pose to you and anyone who has your same viewpoint. Is it this hard for you guys to accept something different? Do you have this much of an issue imagining a young person of color turning on this movie on their Disney Plus account or being taken to the theaters to finally see people like them represented in a different type of way? Does it hurt you this much that we're excited for something new for us? Does Ariel having a darker pigmentation, having curls or locks in her hair, affect you that much when it doesn't change the source material or the character in the slightest?
Have a good day.
Another
I want to thank Ivy, Anita, and I want to steer y'all over to her page because she has a lot of good commentary for my African sister. And Ivy, Anita, check her out. Check her out and check out her commentary. Because I really, really think that she wakes people up. I call her my grandbaby. And, I really liked this commentary. Because what it is the fear of a black planet has been around for a while. And unfortunately, because white folk have been trained to be in control and to see their whiteness everywhere, equality seems like oppression to them. For us to be equal with them makes them feel like something is wrong. Yes, something is wrong. What's wrong is you should never have been playing that game, and the structure and the landscape should have never been laid down this way in the first place. The Quran says that Allah made us into tribes and families that we may get to know one another. You know, and not antagonize each other and not think that I'm better than you or you better than me, but that's not what has happened, is it? And for control and money purposes, European has corrupt the whole world. And there I said it, and there I mean it, and I'm standing in it. Y'all have corrupted the whole planet where to the point you got little black girls where they bring grown black girls to tears to see the joy on these black girls' faces to see somebody look like them. Because you orchestrated a world where they're not represented at all. And you don't even have a problem with it. You like it like that. That's the way you want it. But it's a new day. Because equality does seem like oppression. But it's not. And you won't have to get with the program. Because no matter what you try to do, you can't kill black and brown people. Because we are the majority of the population on the planet. If you killed all of us, let's say something miraculously happened and you did, you would kill yourself too. You understand that? How dare you make Cleopatra a white woman? As much as I like Elizabeth Taylor, to make Cleopatra a white woman and don't have a problem with it. Jesus, Moses, all these people that you knew lived in a climate where a white person couldn't survive. And you take it, represent it, package it, plagiarize it, and represent it back to society as truth. And your mind now is so messed up that when you see a little black girl playing Ariel, you freaking lose your mind. You lose your mind. Y'all need help. And shame on the forefathers who set this country up. Shame on y'all, because they knew they would be dead. And they wouldn't have to be alive when all this shit start coming into fruition, where the truth start coming out. They knew they would be dead and gone. And they couldn't foresee the future to this degree. And because they didn't know enough. But let me shout it out and let me make it very clear. 9/10 of the world's population is black and brown, not white. Not white. With that being said, you guys, I don't know. I'm taking my grandbaby to see it, that's for sure. And a black woman can play Ariel. If a white woman can play Cleopatra, a real person in history, then surely a black woman can play a fictional cartoon person like Ariel. What y'all think about it? Family, I need your comments on this one. Tell me what you think. Okay. I'm done with it.